China aims to launch its digital currency before the Winter Olympics. Around the globe, countries like England, Canada, Sweden, Singapore, and the US are either researching or piloting their own digital currency. But every day, we're already making millions of payments digitally. So what makes this new digital currency different? This is Calcutta, a beautiful city in northeastern India. If you'd like to pay a visit, say from Toronto, Canada, one of the things you need to take care of is money. You can either exchange your Canadian dollar into ruby at home, or like most people, buy some paper ruby when you land in the local airport. When your cash is about to run out, you find an exchange shop and buy some more. You might find it inconvenient to pack this paper money or looking for foreign exchange. You're also probably worrying someone's gonna steal it. Now imagine this. You do your exchange at home, then download an app called Indian Digital Wallet. Then put your ruby there. The digital wallet are accepted by all merchants and people in India so that you don't need to carry any paper cash anymore. You don't need internet connection to make a payment. This is central bank digital currency. Unlike the cash balance in your bank account, central bank digital currency doesn't require you to open up a bank account. Central bank creates the money. They can even directly put money into your digital wallet. These digital currency have the exact same use and value as paper money, except for they only exist in digital form, meaning you can't go to the bank or ATM and convert them to paper cash. Digital currency is not something new. They already exist in many forms, mostly known as cryptocurrency, such as Bitcoin, Ethereum, Tether, or XRP. But unlike central bank digital currency, these currencies are not issued or managed by a central authority. Some of them operate under the blockchain public ledger, some under its own network and protocol. Central bank digital currency, on the other hand, are issued and backed by the country's central bank. Within a country, it can make sure everybody accepts it as a form of payment. But why all of a sudden in the past 3 years, central bank around the world started pinching the idea of digital currencies? And more importantly, how are these so-called digital currencies is going to impact us? An increasing number of people believe cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin is the future of finance. Since there are only 21 million Bitcoins to be mined in total, Bitcoin earned its name the digital gold. First of all, people don't love cryptocurrencies for no reason. Using cryptocurrency like XRP, moving money across the border can take as little as 3 seconds. Payments are quickly sent and received in the local currency on either side of a transaction. There's no bank interference and much lower fees making cross-border transactions using Bitcoin. Unlike bank records your every transaction, Bitcoin transactions take place only between you and the receiver. Maybe the best feature of the cryptocurrency is that it makes cross-border transactions much faster with no third party involved, thus much lower cost. But these cryptocurrencies also have disadvantages. If buying coffee takes 10 minutes, it's probably not a very pleasant experience. And that's how it feels when you shop using Bitcoin. It's notoriously slow. Cryptocurrencies' prices are extremely volatile, which makes majority of the merchants around the globe don't take them as a form of payment. Most cryptocurrencies are mainly used for trading, which was largely driven by speculation rather than intrinsic values. Because the transactions are confidential and no regulation is put in place, Bitcoin was used for gambling, black market trades, and illegal payments. Each year, criminals laundered billions of dollars using crypto exchanges. Despite its scarcity, Bitcoin is probably far from being the gold in the world of digital currency. Along with cryptocurrencies, in 2019, Facebook announced its plan to launch its own digital currency, Libra. With billions of users, these tech giants could seriously threaten the monetary sovereignty of the central bank. This makes central banks begin to think about monetary alternatives. According to the Bank of International Settlements in 2020, 80% of the central banks around the world are engaged in some work in CBDC. Some countries have already launched CBDC, such as Brazil. Some countries are actively piloting. For example, People's Bank of China are aiming for widespread domestic use of its digital currency, DCEP, but the 2022 Winter Olympics in Beijing. Some says it may be many more years before they know what to do about it. With most central banks actively researching and piloting their new digital currencies, now it becomes pretty convincing that something new is coming. But is it going to bring a big change in our lives? Domestically, not much really. In October 2020, China gave millions of digital yuan to citizens in Shenzhen for a taste. But some users say they prefer existing shopping tools like Alipay. With the day-to-day payment, paying using central bank digital wallet or existing payment app like WeChat Pay or Alipay doesn't really make a difference. You download an app, scan QR code, shop as usual. Economist PwC China says, in order to promote the digital currency's use, Beijing may bundle it with subsidies, pension accounts, or state sector paychecks. If used domestically, you probably won't feel much of a difference, but when you make cross-border transfers, CDBC might come in handy. Now it takes days when you're trying to send money to friends or family in another country, not mentioning the hefty transaction fee. Central bank digital currency may take minutes or even seconds at a lower cost. The exact technical details is yet to be designed and may be many years ahead, but it's good to have a better alternative to transfer money using SWIFT, which is honestly ancient. According to the World Bank, over 22% of the adults around the world have no bank account or payment service account. More specifically in China, there are still 60 million people who don't have a bank account. Government money goes through layers of distribution to land into the hands of people. Some people don't even get the subsidies because of corruption and mismanagement. With CDBC, central bank is able to send money directly to the people's digital wallets, and these CDBC can be used without internet connection. While CDBC can make cross-border transfer much faster and at a lower cost, just like cryptocurrency, it's not without its own risks or concerns. Unlike Bitcoin, CDBC in nature is centralized, meaning central bank controls the supply. Some intend to use distributed ledger technology like blockchain, which makes transactions anonymous and traceable. Some don't use blockchain, which allows the central bank to track every transaction, for example, China's CDBC. If every transaction you made with the CDBC is on central bank's book, the good part is they're able to analyze consumer behavior to manage the economy better. They can detect any illicit flows of funds, such as money laundering or terrorist financing. For some of you, you may not want someone to monitor what you're paying for all the time. For others, transaction data are already in bank's book or third-party service providers like Visa or WeChat, so they may be okay with it. Put that aside, digital currency could disrupt the current financial system. Your deposits at the commercial banks are banks' major source of funding. Central bank digital currency could be a direct competitor to commercial banks. When you convert your cash in your bank account into CDBC, it causes commercial bank losing their major source of funding, which may result in higher deposit rate, interest rate for loans, moreover, makes it difficult to provide the credit needed to fuel the economy. Although central banks around the world are actively researching and piloting their own digital currencies, the actual design and implementation may be years in the making. Exactly how it will play out? Guess we have to wait and see.